Okay, all right. So hello, dears. Good day again. So this is now the part 2 of biochemical testing part 2. So for this part, we're gonna discuss, I think, the most TMI siguro na parts sa biochemical testing, sa tanang parts, I believe. Because again, we will discuss a lot of tests here which are really very much significant. Very, very common, very important tests na usually dyan gina-perform sa routine clinical lab. Because again, this group of bacteria, your Enterobacteriaceae or your gram-negative bacilli is, I think, one of the largest group of bacteria that are present or, yeah, that can cause human disease, okay? All right? So again, this is the biochemical testing for identification of the Enterobacteriaceae or gram-negative bacilli. Okay, all right. And sa akong board exam sa microbiology, daghan kayo nigawas, ani, like mga case studies, and then you identify the organism based on the biochemical results nila. So it's important that as early as now, ma-internalize ninyo, ma-aware na mo sa unsa ka intense pud ang information ani na topic, and ma-master na ninyo hinay-hinay. Okay? Para pag-abot sa review, pag-abot sa boards, easy na lang. Chicken na lang ni. Okay? Alright, so again, this is your Enterobacteriaceae or your gram-negative bacilli. Okay, alright. So we'll start first with the select members of Enterobacteriaceae. We have the different tribes and genera. So for the first one is the Escherichiaceae. Okay, so of course you have Escherichia and Shigella. You have the Edwardsiellii. That's Edwardsiella ang genera. For Salmonellii is your Salmonella. Citrobacteriaceae is Citrobacter, of course. Klebsiellii is your Klebsiella, Enterobacter, Pantoea, Chronobacter, Hafnia, and Serratia. And Proteae is your Proteus, Providentia, and Morganella. So these are the major tribes and the genera found in each, okay, of select members of your Enterobacteriaceae. Okay, all right. Now we go now to the general characteristics. Ah, napaday last. Yersinii is, of course, Yersinia. Again, the different tribes and representative genera found in each tribe. Okay. Now we go now to the general characteristics of your Enterobacteriaceae. Now, what are Enterobacteriaceae? Now, your Enterobacteriaceae are gram-neg. Okay, gram-neg, non-spore-forming rods. Okay, and when you say Enterobacteriaceae, they are the gram-negative bacilli or the bacteria that usually inhabit your gut microbiota or your gastrointestinal microbiota or normal flora. So, normal flora sa inyong tinae. Okay, that's Enterobacteriaceae. Now, most of the time, they are normal flora. But there are times na mahimos lang opportunist or opportunistic pathogens, meaning when the patient becomes immunocompromised or when they are subjected to another environment. But there are members of the Enterobacteriaceae that are not found in the normal flora gyud. Like, they are really pathogens. Example, Shigella, Salmonella, and Yersinia. These are really considered pathogens, okay? True pathogens of the enteric system or the gastrointestinal system. You have Salmonella, Shigella, and Yersinia. Salmonella, Shigella, and Yersinia. Okay? Ayan. Yersinia. Okay. Alright. So these are really considered to be pathogens na gyud of the gastrointestinal system. Alright? Okay. So again, that's for the description of Enterobacteriaceae. Now we go now to their general characteristics in terms of biochem. Okay. So first one is, of course, they're all motile. Okay? Motile sila with peritrichous flagella. Peritrichous, meaning all around the organism. Except for three organisms. We have Sky. Ayan. Sky. So, Shigella. Klebsiella. Okay. And Yersinia enterocolitica at 37 degrees Celsius. So, at room temp, Yersinia enterocolitica, Yersinia is motile. But at 37 degrees Celsius, non-motile na siya. Okay? So again, all are motile. Except, again, kinsa? Sky, Shigella, Klebsiella, and Yersinia. Enterocolitica. Or, yeah, Yersinia. Okay. Ayan. Okay, next, they are facultative anaerobes. Okay? So they can live with or without oxygen. Okay, next, all ferment glucose. Okay, so when you say all ferment glucose, tanan sila gamito ng glucose. Alright? So, walay pulos, na mo identify kag Enterobacteriaceae using glucose fermentation na test because all of them ferment glucose. So, dili nimo sila ma-identify. Okay? All right. Most again are normal flora, some are pathogenic. They are all oxidase negative, okay? Oxidase test negative sila except for Plesiomonas shigelloides. Okay, so Plesiomonas shigelloides, saray exception. They are all catalase positive except kakinsa Shigella dysentery. Okay, dysentery. And they all reduce nitrate to nitrite. Okay, nitrate reduction positive sila except for Erwinia and Pantoea agglomerans. So as you can see, these are all general characteristics of Enterobacteriaceae. Now, because they exhibit all of these characteristics, sila gyud, munang we go now to individual tests to identify them because they have their own characteristic reactions. Okay. Alright. So please take note again. Oxidase neg, catalase positive. Okay. So our mnemonic ana is sipon. Okay. Sipon. Sigingi sipon. Catalase positive, oxidase negative. Okay. Sipon. Catalase positive, oxidase negative. And please take note kinsa itong mga nai exceptions. Okay. Alright. Again, they're all motile with peri. Peritrichous flagella. Exact kinsa? Sky. Okay. Alright. Ayan. So that's all for the first general characteristics palang. Okay. So general characteristics palang. They're, it's already TMI, pero hinahinayrag, repeat, og memorize, ma-memorize, rag yun na siya. Okay? Facultative anaerobes, catalase positive, oxidase negative, reduced nitrate to nitrite, you have, so pa to, facultative anaerobes, motile with peritrichous flagella, yeah, etc. You'll get the hang of it. Okay. And remember, reduced nitrate to nitrite, remember sa atong inyohang AUBF, right? Muna natay nitrite na test sa atong reagent pad, di ba? To detect UTI. And, unsa may gingon sa yung discussion, di ba? Usually, we see that if nitrite positive, it's mostly because the bacteria has nitrate reductase na enzyme or can reduce nitrate to nitrite. And kinsa lang example, of course, ang mga Enterobacteriaceae. Because again, they can reduce nitrate to nitrite. Okay. Alright. Ayan. So we'll now go to the different... kanisa diay. Okay. So basically, this is the flow chart on how we identify your... Enterobacteriaceae. As you can see, medyo daghan kayo siya, no? And we'll go individually sa kanisila. Okay? Alright, don't worry. Kalma lang ta. Okay? Alright, ayan. So we now go to the different tests. So first one is, of course, the oxidase test. I know na-mention niya siya sa gram-neg cocci na biochem testing for Neisseria, Veillonella, and Moraxella, which are all, again, oxidase positive. Now, for biochem testing, again, all Enterobacteriaceae are oxidase negative. Please take note. Except for, kisa itong oxidase positive, Plesiomonas shigelloides. Okay? Please take note. Alright. Okay. Ayan. So, it detects the presence of the enzyme cytochrome oxidase. So, it detects the presence of the enzyme cytochrome oxidase. And then, so, ang principle is, ang atong substrate is tetramethyl P phenylenediamine dihydrochloride or p-aminodimethylaniline oxalate. And in the presence of cytochrome oxidase, it now becomes indophenol, which is color purple. Okay, so therefore, atong positive reaction is, of course, the development of a purple color within 10 seconds. Okay, so this is the oxidase test. So positive na to is purple because of the product na indophenol. Okay, alright, ayan. And negative is walay color. Alright, so asa man ang expected na results sa Enterobacteriaceae ani is of course this one because they are all oxidase negative. Okay, exact again for Plesiomonas shigelloides. Okay. Another test is of course the nitrate reduction because again, di ba, we mentioned ganina nitrate reduction. We detect also the enzyme here, ang enzyme that is nitrate reductase or nitroso reductase. Okay, so principle, nitrate in the presence of nitrate reductase or nitroso reductase becomes nitrite. Okay, nitrite and adana to og reagent which is NN dimethyl alpha naphthalamine and sulfanilic acid. Sulfanilic acid and nitrite. So ang nitrite and sulfanilic acid, okay, they form a diazonium salt. Okay, diazonium salt. And this diazonium salt ang muad ang mu combine sa NN dimethyl. Okay, siya'y mo combine ana. Okay, sa NN dimethyl. And because of their combination, dira na mo create og red azo dye, which is the positive result. Now, if it's negative, we will further the procedure. So if negative, we then add the solution with zinc dust. Okay, because again, We want to confirm if it's really negative. Okay. All right. Because again, in the presence of zinc dust, ang zinc dust na ang mo convert sa nitrate to nitrite. Okay. And because of that, mahimong red azodine. So it's true negative if mo red azodine na siya, which means nahimo siyang red azodine lang or nipula na siya after addition of zinc dust. Because ang zinc dust na ang ni convert sa nitrate to nitrite. It's not the enzyme found in the bacteria. So it's really negative. Gets? Okay. So again, let's say reaction number one. Okay. So nitrate again, di ba? Let's say ang kagaw na ay nitrate reductase. So of course, by itself, ma-convert niya nitrate to nitrite. And with this reagent, mo red azodine. So positive. How about, let's say ni negative siya. Okay. So we now need to confirm it by the addition of zinc dust. Now, if negative gives us a reaction number one, sa reaction number two, dapat red azodine ang ma-produce niya. Why? Because again, the nitrate in the reaction number one is not converted to nitrite. Because again, we're assuming na diri negative siya because ang kagaw walay nitrate reductase. So walay mo convert sa nitrate to nitrite. Okay. Now, in the reaction number two, naana may zinc dust na mo convert sa nitrate. Therefore, muna siyang karun pa siya ni red because, again, nanay zinc dust na ni-convert sa nitrate to nitrite. Gets? So, muna siyang, if red azodine sa reaction number 2, okay, true negative gud siya from the reaction number 1. Gets? I hope na-gets ra. Okay. Alright. So, again, our reaction number 1, negative ni siya if walay red azodine. Okay, let's say lang ha, focus na sa negative na reaction. So let's say wala ni red, so therefore negative. So you want to confirm good if it's really negative. So you now proceed to the reaction number 2. You add zinc dust. Now let's say pag-add ni mo zinc dust, ni red azodine. So that means it's really true negative. Why? Because the zinc dust was the one that reduced nitrate to nitrite. Okay? Because again, the nitrate present was not reduced by the bacteria in reaction number 1. Kay wala man siya nitrate reductase na enzyme. Gets? Okay, all right. And for this one, in the case na positive siya diri, pag-add mo sa zinc dust, of course, dili na siya mo change og color because the nitrate in the first reaction already have been reduced to nitrite or mga gases, nitrous oxide, nitrogen gas na reduced na siya. So wala na yung ma-reduce ang zinc dust na nitrate. Munang wala na yung color change, which means it's really positive for the nitrate reductase enzyme. Gets ra? Again, if positive na siya here, okay, positive na siya, red azodine na sa reaction number 1. Pag add ni mong zinc dust this time, of course, it will have no color change anymore because again, wala na yung nitrate na present kay na-convert na tanan to nitrite. Alright? Or to these gases ba. And in pag add sa zinc dust, wala na may nitrate na ma-convert ang zinc dust to nitrite. So, munang walay color change. Okay? I do hope that nagets ra ha. Okay? Alright, that's for nitrate reduction. Okay, so here's an example again of your nitrate reduction results. So, we add a Durham tube. Okay, the Durham tube is the tube that captures the gas because in the presence of nitrate reduction, mo release o gas ang ubang organisms in some pathways na ilang ginagamit ang nitrate. Okay? So, ang Durham tube ang mo-collect sa gas. Okay. Alright. So, from the left, alright. So, ang number 1 is positive, no gas. Okay? Number 2 is positive with gas. Okay? As you can see. Alright? Na ay gas here. I'm not sure lang if... okay. Ang number 2 is positive siya with gas because instead of a nitrate, ang nitrate, na-convert ang nitrate sa kagaw to nitrite, but then, na-convert pa dyan sa kagaw ang nitrite to other gases, kato ng N2 and O2. So, it's still positive. Okay, na may bubble sa Durham tube. So, it means it's positive. Bahalag wala ni red, okay, ang second tube. Because it could indicate that the organism has converted nitrate to nitrite and further converted pag yun nitrite to the byproducts na gases katong N2O, NO2, N2. Okay? And that is captured by the Durham tube. So that's positive ang second. Okay, number 3, it's still positive, di ba? Kay, naanay zinc dust, di ba, kaning black. Pero walay color change na hitabo, di ba? Remember ang discussion from the previous slide, right? Because again, walay na yung nitrite na present, kay na-convert na tanan sa kagaw using its enzyme nitrate reductase to nitrite. Wala na gamiton ang zinc dust to convert to nitrate. Munang the color or walay color change na itrabo. Okay? All right. Ayan. And number four is, of course, uninoculated with a Durham tube. So, unsa nang Durham tube? Inverted tube that traps the gas. Okay? All right. But generally, ang positive reaction jud for nitrate reduction is red azodide. Or more red ang pares anang na pinaka-left. Okay? So, red siya. Okay. Again, excuse me. All Enterobacteriaceae are nitrate reducers, okay, or they can reduce nitrate to nitrite, except for Erwinia and Pantoea agglomerans, okay. All right, okay, next test, we have the ONPG test. Now, for the ONPG test, it detects the enzyme beta-galactosidase because in the fermentation of lactose, your organisms usually use two enzymes. You have lactose permease, okay, and beta-galactosidase, okay. Now, there are some organisms na ang there are some organisms that have both, but na ubang organisms na kanira ang naa ang beta galactosidase, and we use that here in the ONPG test. Okay, and our agent that is O nitrophenyl beta D galactopyranoside. That's our reagent. ONPG. The meaning of ONPG. O nitrophenyl beta D galactopyranoside. So ONPG in the presence of beta-galactosidase, it will now convert it or break it down to galactose and O-nitrophenol, which gives a yellow compound. Ayan. So, ang positive result is, of course, yellow, and negative is colorless. Now, why do we perform this ONPG test? We usually perform this to determine the rapid and the late lactose fermenters. Now, when you say rapid lactose fermenters, they have both two enzymes, lactose permease and beta-galactosidase. And kinsa ni sila? Of course, kablo na mo ani si Eke, Escherichia, Klebsiella, and Enterobacter. So, when you say rapid lactose permease, they ferment lactose within usually 18 hours. Okay, so rapid, because again, they have two enzymes, ferments lactose, again, within mga 18 to 24 hours. So, paspas gigaayo. All right. Whereas your late lactose fermenters, late lactose, because they only have one enzyme, which is beta-galactosidase. And we have these organisms, Salmonella, Shigella sonnei, Serratia, Hafnia, Yersinia, and Citrobacter. So usually, mga after 48 hours na sila, after 2 days ba of incubation. Okay, dito pa siya mo color pink on makonki. Okay, because again, they are late lactose fermenters. Why? Because they only have one enzyme, beta-galactosidase. Whereas ang rapid lactose fermenters, they have two, lactose permease and beta-galactosidase. Okay, all right. Now, unsa itong mnemonic for late lactose fermenters? You have sit, sir, your half, sashi is late. Oh, di ba? Sit, sir, your half sashi is late. Okay. Credits to Ma'am Vanessa of Lemar. Okay. Sit, sir, your half sashi is late. Citrobacter, Serratia, Yersinia, Hafnia, Salmonella, Enterica, subspecies, Arizonae, and Shigella, Sonnei. Okay, di ba? So, na natin mga mnemonics dyan. Sit, sir, your half sashi is late. Okay, so makabulo na ka, late. So, kinsa itong mga late lactose fermenters? Sit, sir, your half sashi is late. So, ayaw na kutubog mnemonics, dapat alam ang meaning sa mnemonics. Guys, ha, kay, bahalag na kay mnemonics pagabot sa exam, nalimot ka sa meaning pate, afatay. Wala dyan po kayo ma-answer. Okay, alright. Ayan. That's for, again, ONPG test. Now, if you're asked, para kakinsa ning ONPG test, para kakinsa ka bumabangon, char. It's usually used for the late lactose fermenters, ang ONPG test. Because remember, we're detecting lactose, beta-galactosidase. Okay, and we usually use it again for the late lactose fermenters. Although ang rapid lactose fermenters na asalay beta galactosidase, it's evident na manguday yun because after 18 to 24 hours palang incubation, pink dye ng colonies. Whereas, kaning late lactose mudugay po dyan siya, maybe it would take about 2 days pagyud until mu pink na ang colonies. Because again, they only have one enzyme, which is beta galactosidase. Alright, so again, para kaginsa ng ONPG, usually for late lactose fermenters. Okay, alright. Ayan. Okay. So, again, ONPG test. And we also have, of course, the non-lactose fermenters. Like, bahalag pila pa naka-days ni mo incubate, colorless lagi na yung colonies. And the remaining members of your Enterobacteriaceae, other species of Salmonella, other species of Shigella, Proteus providentia, Edwardsiella, Erwinia, and Morganella. So, nalimot ko sa ako ang mnemonics, ani. Pero easy na mo, SSPPMEE. So, mura siya you know, nagbalik-balik lang letters, alright? Basta again, kabalo mo sa meaning sa mga letters, ha? Sa yung mnemonics. Okay, so S-S-P-P-M-E-E-E. Okay, alright. Ayan. So, Salmonella, Shigella, other species of Salmonella and Shigella. Proteus, Providentia, Morganella, and Edwardsella and Erwinia. Kanyang PPM, guys, usually they're all magkauban yun na sila. Like, the trio yun na sila, sige. Diba, they're all under the same triprotee. They also have quite the same na mga biochemical results po, ang PPM. Proteus, Providentia, and Morganella. As in, like, kanadyo silang tulo. It's very easy to remember po. Kasi sige silang kuyog. Okay? Alright, ayan. Okay, that's for ONPG. Okay. And, yes, for the next test, of course, you have oxidation fermentation. Na-mentioning ni sa itong gram-positive cocci. Again, you determine whether an organism uses sugar either anaerobically, fermentation, or aerobically, oxidation. So, indicators either phenol red or bromothymol blue. Carbohydrate is any single sugar. Pwedeng glucose, pwedeng fructose ba, sucrose, lactose, whatever. Depending, again, on the need of the organism. Okay? Or, yeah, on the organism that you want to identify. And ang principle, again, carbohydrate, either fermentation or oxidation. Again, ang results, byproducts, ana, are acids. Okay? And gas. Nayoba na mo produce gas. Now, in the presence, again, of phenol red, since acids man, so from red, na uninoculated, and then in the presence of acid, it now becomes a yellow color. And that signifies the positive result. Okay? Alright, so still the same, diba? We have aerobic, walay mineral oil, and anaerobic, na ay mineral oil to produce the anaerobic na environment. Okay? Alright? And then of course, number one, fermenter and oxidizer, ni yellow ang both, or we simply call that a fermenter. Again, number two, non-fermenter, oxidizer siya. Because again, yellow lang siya sa open tube, pero red lang sa closed tube. Okay, so meaning, mugamit siya glucose in the presence of oxygen ragyod. So oxidizer. And number three, non-fermenter or non-oxidizer, non-utilizer, or remember atong term for that is asaccharolytic. Kinsa ganitong gram-negative cocci na asaccharolytic? Si Moraxella catarrhalis. Okay, dapat na ano na ngayon, alright? Okay. Gram-neg cocci, asaccharolytic. Of course, that's Moraxella catarrhalis. Okay. Alright. Ayan. And of course, if yellow rapud siya in the sealed tube, example, red ni pero yellow here, okay, it means it's a fermenter pa rin. Because it only uses oxygen, it only uses glucose or ferments the sugar in the absence of oxygen. Okay. Alright. Next, we also have the fermentation test. Do not be confused, ani. Ang fermentation test, it's usually used lang yun for fermentation. So, it's determining the ability of the organism to ferment carbohydrates. And usually, again, still mga sugars. Indicator is still phenol red. You have carbohydrate is any single sugar. And principle is carbohydrate in the presence of, again, in fermentation, again, ang products na to are acids and gas. And which changes the color of phenol red from red na uninoculated to yellow. Again, yellow. So here's an example of a result. Let's say, ayan. So unsa man itong result, ana? Unsa may mga giferment na sugar sa imuhang organism, if in any. So it's of course, the organism is a glucose and sucrose fermenter. Whereas, it is a lactose, rhamnose, arabinose, and mannitol non-fermenter. Okay, kay red raman siya. So katong ni yellow, mutuyahang positive. Okay? And please take note, this is a broth, guys, ha? Broth ni siya. Dili siya semi-solid. Na uban, ang OF, katong oxidation fermentation, semi-solid, ang medium. Alright? But ang kanisila, broth. Okay? Broth. Alright. So again, glucose and sucrose fermenter, lactose, rhamnose, arabinose, and mannitol non-fermenter. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Now, for the next part of the video, we'll now continue to the rest of the tests. Medyo ubay-ubay pag yun siya, guys. So, kapit lang dyan. Okay? Alright.